axillary nerve. It is the chief nerve of the shoulder. It arises from the posterior cord of brachial plexus. Root value: anterior primary rami of C5, C6 spinal nerves. Important clinical relations. In the axilla, it lies posterior to the third part of the axillary artery, lateral to the radial nerve. It lies posterior to the third part of the axillary artery, lateral to the radial nerve. It lies on the subscapularis muscle. In the quadrangular space, it enters the quadrangular space where it divides into anterior and posterior division. So from the axilla, it enters the quadrangular space where the axillary nerve divides into anterior division and posterior division. The anterior division of the axillary nerve is accompanied by the posterior circumflex humeral artery. Branches and distribution. Articular branch to the shoulder joint. Muscular branches to deltoid and teres minor. So the branch to the teres minor arises from the posterior division, which presents a pseudoganglion. Cutaneous distribution. After supplying the deltoid muscle, the axillary nerve continues as upper lateral cutaneous nerve of arm, which supplies the skin over the lower half of the deltoid region, of the shoulder. Applied anatomy. Injury to axillary nerve results in paralysis of the deltoid muscle, the chief muscle of the shoulder. So this results in loss of contour of the shoulder region. Abduction of the shoulder is lost, so abduction is not possible. Loss of sensation over the skin of the lower part of the deltoid region. Musculocutaneous nerve. It is the chief nerve of the anterior compartment of arm. It is the nerve of lateral cord of brachial plexus. Root value: anterior primary rami of C5, C6 and C7 spinal nerves. Important clinical relations. In the axilla, the musculocutaneous nerve lies lateral to the third part of the axillary artery. This is the third part of axillary artery. It lies lateral to the third part of the axillary artery. See, it is arising from the lateral cord and it lies lateral to the third part of the axillary artery. In the arm, see, in the arm you see, this is the shorter biceps, coracobrachialis, longer biceps. So this is the biceps muscle, this is the brachialis muscle. So Front of the arm consists of mainly three muscles: brachialis, biceps, and coracobrachialis. In the arm, it enters the arm by piercing the coracobrachialis. Then it descends between the biceps and brachialis. Okay. Near the lower part of the arm, okay, it pierces the deep fascia. And continues as lateral cutaneous nerve of forearm. Branches and distribution. Articular branch to the elbow joint. Muscular branch to coracobrachialis, biceps, and brachialis. See, the branch, the coracobrachialis, arises before it pierces the coracobrachialis. Cutaneous branch. See, the muscular cutaneous nerve, which continues as the lateral cutaneous nerve of forearm, supplies the skin over the lateral half of anterior surface of forearm. So this is the cutaneous distribution. Applied anatomy. Injury to musculocutaneous nerve results in paralysis of biceps and brachialis. Brachialis is a powerful flexor, so loss of flexion at the elbow joint. Biceps, otherwise known as supinator longus, is a powerful supinator. So supination of the forearm is lost, hence it results in pronation of the forearm. Loss of sensation over the lateral half of the anterior surface of forearm.